All right, good morning, everybody. We're live out on the side of the Fox 8 building here. AJ Petitti, how's it going?
Things are wonderful.
Let's get a quick garden update, and then we'll head right to the segment.
Beautiful. So tomatoes, everything is looking good. We saw a little white fly last week. We sprayed it with Captain Jack's. Mm-hmm. It's doing phenomenal. This morning, just keeping an eye out for the blossom end rot with calcium. Mm-hmm. And also, the tomatoes need a little bit of midsummer jump. So I hit them with tomato tone this morning, and then a little bit of Captain Jack's just to keep an eye on the white fly. Keep that down. The zucchini have a lot of blossoms. You are seeing that powdery mildew kick in.
Right.
Don't sweat it. They'll keep producing from now through the end of August.
Okay.
Peppers really still producing. They're looking good. Potatoes looks like they're going to be ready to harvest very soon, so in the next week or two.
When you do the tomato tone, you put a little bit right at the base and then put a little water for it to soak in?
Yeah. Yeah, okay. Just put it right at the base of the tomato, okay. And then just, you know, either water it in,
mm-hmm.
Use a watering wand, or if it's going to rain, do it before it rains, and then you'll be in really good shape.
Okay.
So, but the carrots, just checked on those. If you're seeing a lot of bunching, go through, thin those out, and those will be in great shape. And then the herbs, just make sure you're harvesting. So the basil, everything that you're seeing, parsley, don't let it go to flower.
Right.
Just make sure that that's going to flower. And then now's a great time, especially as we're in midsummer in Northeast Ohio,
mm-hmm.
there is a lot of shade. We're blessed, we've got a lot of trees,
right.
a great canopy. So really just highlighting some stuff that does really well in shade
mm-hmm.
and different ways to use it. So this is probably my favorite bush for the shade. So it's a viburnum, and it comes in a lot of different varieties.
Mm-hmm.
This is a fragrant viburnum. It's a Carlisi viburnum, a Korean spice. It's got a really sweet smelling flower.
Mm-hmm.
It blooms in spring. They all mostly bloom in spring, but they're deer resistant, they're shade tolerant, they hold up really well, they're tough as nails, and they get a really nice size to them. This is a heuchera, so you can see the really cool foliage.
I've seen those before.
And they're everywhere, and they're actually, because of their shade tolerance and their deer resistance, they really hold up well, and people are using them in everything. And the number of colors that they're coming out with those is really from bright yellows like this grass
mm-hmm.
to deep purples and everything in between. And they're really cool in containers. So you can mix that with some begonias, some other stuff in a container, and it does really well. This is a Brunera, and again, it's very deer resistant, which is cool with a lot of the shade plants. So this has that bright, shiny silver foliage. Hosta, of course.
Sure.
So, you can't go wrong with hosta. They are not deer resistant. So if you've got any kind of deer problem, you're serving them lunch.
Yes.
But on the flip side, they are beautiful. So
yes.
If you can't have them, and there's a lot of sprays that you can use.
Sure.
You know, you could use plant skid, liquid fence.
Stuff that doesn't stink like some of the stuff that we used to
Well,
use.
Liquid fence.
Well, liquid fence is a little different.
That's a little rough.
Yeah, yeah.
But deer stopper is a great one, and it doesn't stink. And that's actually probably one of my favorites. And then ferns are wonderful. These are probably my favorite shade plant. They're great in planters also. And then some astilbe. And then really just your typical, of all the annuals, probably the begonias are really beautiful in a container or in the ground. They get big, beautiful flowers. And then sun patience is a great new introduction
mm-hmm.
as you're looking through here. So these have large flowers. They look almost like a New Guinea, but they'll do well in sun or in shade, and they bloom nonstop all summer. So if you want that big mass look of impatience, it's such a great way to go.
You know, we're entering, and we talked about this earlier on the morning show, a dry stretch. You know, we've had some rain this morning, but we're not looking at any rain till early next week. Hanging baskets, you know, when it gets hot like this and dry, I always tell people water the baskets, because those things can dry out real quick and you don't realize until it's too late.
Yeah. Yeah, you want to make sure that you water them every single day. So if it's raining outside and they're getting moisture from the rain, and you know that it's a substantial amount of rain, or if you lift a basket and it feels really light, make sure that you're watering it. But as a rule of thumb, you want to water those once a day. On really hot days like what we had over this past weekend,
sure.
even twice a day.
Right.
It sounds like a lot, but they dry out so quickly, especially if you get the smaller ones.
Mm-hmm.
If they don't water them, they tend to lose their flowers and they'll reset.
Right.
So by watering them, and then just feed them about once a month with Osmocote, and you'll be in great shape.
Good stuff. AJ,
cool.
Always a pleasure.
Good to see you.